page 222, beginning with the paragraph of Bechol Zeh Yuvan. Connecting now, what does Hilula mean, and what does it signify in the Aveda, the service of a person? It says that Bechol Zeh Yuvan HaKesher Aveda Sa'odam L'Inyan HaHilula. But all this will understand the connection between the Aveda, the service of a person to his Creator, L'Inyan HaHilula, to the Inyan of Hilula of a Yortzeit. Hi, Alma, that this world is compared to a party place. People come, people go. The Aveda, the previous Aveda mentioned that it's the union of Hiluch, which means a Nisham in this physical world, a soul in this physical world, whatever it does. It elevates to a high level, which is referred to Hiluch, that it's not within the proportion of the previous level. It is similar to a chasen, to a wedding, and that's why the aved in this world, after this world, is considered ilula, a chasen. Kedik shem shal yedei a chasen. After marriage, there's children. Kedik shem shal yedei a chasen neilud mitzias chadosha. That in the same sense. Through the chasana, through a wedding, there is created a new being, shazel tachlas achasana pruorvu, that then they multiply, which means they create, there's more children that come, a new being, a new creation, through the couple, aver ezal yedei yiridas hanesham ez lamata v'kim amatei amitza shalahem nasa inya shalei loda chadosha. The same thing is also in the same sense, that when a couple is in this physical world, so then they bring generations, produce generations to come in the same sense in Yishama when it is here the Mato, and it is in this physical world with the body, together with the body, so it is like a couple that accomplishes through Teiru Mitzvahs an infinite revelation, a revelation of the infinite light. Gilui Eirin Sof, Shu Gilui Chodesh V'chulu Kenal. It is a Gilui of the infinite light, which is a new Gilui. So that's why the Aveda, the service in this world, is referred to a wedding. Because in the same way that in a wedding, the result of the wedding is generations to come. And in the same sense, the result of the descent of the Neshama, the soul here, in this physical world, and fulfilling Torah Mitzvahs, accomplishes a revelation of a new light. Ubefrat al piyabir anal shel admor ha-tzemach tzedek. And especially, as the Tzemach Tzedek explains, as we mentioned earlier, Shayichot v'zivuk zehu zivuk pnimish elamayla mizivuk chitzeni demalach. This connection, this interrelationship that there is between by Nishomes is higher yet than there is by malach and by angels, because it's a more essential. This zivuk, which is a zivuk of a chasana, literally a wedding, which this is the difference between a malach and a neshama. A neshama comes down here, the matah, and neshama, then the person gets married. When there's two people together, so then there is a creation of generations to come. In the same, which means that there is an essence that is passed on from generation to generation. This is the union of children, which a child comes from the etzem, from the essence of the father, later developed by the mother in the 9 months of pregnancy. On the other hand, an angel does not have this potential to create such an essence. So this is what the Tzemach Tzedek says, that the yichud that a neshama has, and especially neshamas in this neshama neguf, is something more yet than seichel. As Chassidus explains, just to mention in brief what we mentioned last week, the difference. What the Rebbe explained is there's a difference when a person is a Rav in a Talmud mode, or it's a Av and a Ben, a father and a son. When it comes to a Rav and a Talmud, a teacher and a student, so he's not putting up a new head on the person. The expression is, Akot Kemenet Arushtam, you can't put up a new head on the person. It is only you are developing his mind, you are giving him certain tools, you're teaching him certain topics that will refine his mind, that will give him a different perspective from how to look at things, but you're not really doing anything serious with his mind. You're not doing a new creation. On the other hand, when it comes to a neshama beguf, a father and son, so it is the essence of the father that is passed on to the son. So it's more an inyan of a creation and a relationship, the essence, a creation of the son, and a relationship to the essence of the father. Mashenken Malochim is similar to Rav and Talmud, like a teacher and a student that is giving him only the external part of his mind. Even when the Rav is giving him hashpah, he's not giving him how he understands it. He's giving him the concept, he's explaining the topic, as he could relate it to the Talmud. And as Siddhas explains, that the Rav, the Talmud, is only a tenth of what the Rav is really giving.
Do Malachim have hashpah?
No. They don't have this inyan of kechei loda, this etzim inyan, inyan atzmi they don't have.
Last week you said there was female Malachim.
Yeah, but not a ernst geschäft. I mean, it seems like it's not like zivokish v'ishtei. It's not a real a something of essence. Okay, but hey, yesh levayir, and with this we'll understand also the connection like beimer ilule drashvi. Alpi amavur, as it's explained in many maimorim of like beimer chassidic discourses. Beinyam ativim anoim shevasachem gam yochad. That the pasuk that Rashbi said when he needed to bring rain, as the Zayar says, was hine matayva manoyim, how good and how pleasant it is when brothers sit together. Sheinyan pasuk zeh, what does this pasuk signify? In the higher world, who yichud zo malchus, and the attributes of zo, the six spheres, attributes of malchus. Maybe lidei loda, which this is inyan of zo malchus. Is also the Zohar Malchus is male and female, so this brings about the union of birth. This relates exclusively to the Aveda of the Rashbi, Rav Shimon ben Yochai, which he elaborated and said Peira gave Torah teachings on this pasuk, on this verse. Kimavur badrushim, as it's mentioned in the drushim. This will also explain, it's a beautiful word, that what the Friedrich Rebbe said, the previous Rebbe, that by the Mittler Rebbe, like Beimer, was a day of miracles for children, blessings for children. And they waited a whole year for the blessings for like Beimer. What Shaychas does it have to like Beimer? Ki Inyonisha like Beimer, because the Inyan of like Beimer is Milas Inyan Ayilula, Inyan of Chasana. And what's the end result of a chasana? The end result of a chasana is the inyan of a loda. Shal yideze bo inyan a loda dafka, the inyan of birth. So therefore, this is the inyan that dafka on that day, the mitzvah Rebbe would give brachas. A whole year he would send to his brother. That day he gave brachas. Sent to his brother, Rav Chaim Avraham. Rav Chaim Avraham would receive the request, so he would ask, are you taking upon yourself that the child will grow up a chassid? He said yes, so he put on his hat or his shtreimel and give a bracha. This was his inyan to bring chassidim into the world. In the continuation of the maimer, which we're still speaking about this, here already we're speaking about the maimer of the Tzemach Tzedek in Eira Teira. Derech Agav, you see in our order 55, it says over there, Rei Sichas like Beimer Tavshim Mem. How does the Sikha of like Beimet of Shemem, how does it come in? This is another bio that the Rebbe gives, the connection between children and like Beimet. And the Rebbe says the connection is that we find by the Medrash. The Medrash says that the Marimshai came to Rashbi. There was a couple that came, they were married for over 10 years, they never had any children. So came to the Rashbi, and the Rashbi said that, he told the wife, make a party and take the best thing you have in the house and take it to your